This all started with one mission trip that we went on. We went on to help the aftermath of Hurricane Maria. And over there, we saw the devastation, but we also got to know and learn that a lot of people didn't have power after the hurricane, and even at the point that we were there.
Part of the mission trip was to go to a church service of the church where we were staying. And at the end of the service, the woman stood up in the congregation to explain to everyone there that she had made a solar panel kit to be a generator for her home. We just latched onto that. We met with her days later. She brought her cardboard poster and showed us what she had done. And so when by the time we got back to Roanoke, our pastor, Sung Soo, had already started planning how we were gonna raise money and buy these generators and solar panels to make generators for these people and to bring them back.
And one of the solutions that they came up with was having solar power generators in their houses, because the traditional gas generators, they didn't work. You have to stand in line, even especially after the hurricane, 12 hours to get 1 gallon or one bucket of gasoline to fuel their generator.
It was an evolution of thought from these kind of more permanent type fixtures to something more flexible that gives the church there a tool for disaster response there on that island.
RJ, the pastor, contacted me and asked if it was something he could bring to Common Table, to our district Common Table, which sort of oversees our district ministries. I thought it was a great idea. We didn't demand any church to participate, but invited. It was very invitational.
RJ's idea seemed to be something that was very doable. It was very accessible. It wasn't some sort of pie in the sky kind of thing, but a very practical, reasonable kind of thing that I felt like, yeah, as a district, we certainly can get behind something like this.
The strength that I saw in connection was how people were willing to continue to join hands in mission, despite of all the other things that we see outside of the church.
The agenda now is to distribute the solar powered generators that we've purchased. They're supposed to be in Puerto Rico any day now. They're being shipped there. And then we are going to an island of Vieques off of the main island of Puerto Rico. So we will get the generators shipped there, and then we are going to spend a week distributing and setting up and showing how to maintenance them.
Another neat thing about our connection system is that we have a pastor in our district who is a missionary kid who speaks Spanish. So we asked for a Spanish manual, which the company did not have. So we sent the PDF version to our pastor and said, can you translate it? And he is translating that manual into Spanish for us to make copies and distribute it to the members and the people who will be receiving the solar panel.
I'm really looking forward to not only the experience of going to Puerto Rico and sharing the light, but being able to come back and share it with all those that have supported us along the way and hopefully get everybody excited about more projects similar to what we're doing right now.
It showed our churches, I think, that there are a lot of things we hold in common, and when we work together, we can do really good stuff for Christ.
One other thing that I had learned from this experience is we're definitely stronger together. We're definitely stronger together, and when we are together, we can truly become a body of Christ that can transform this world. And that is my prayer, that we continue to become stronger together, shining that light unto this world.